Hello everybody, Jimmy is Promo here, and I'm going to show you guys an amazing application referred to as SideSync 3.0.
We're sorry, the number you have dialed is not in service at this time.
Now with SideSync 3.0, this is an application you can download for free on the Play Store and also the Galaxy App Store, and it's a way, let's go underneath this, read more, to where you'd be able to put your full functionality of your cell phone onto your tablet, and also be able to drag and drop files. You can be able to type text messages on your keyboard and much, much more if you're using a Galaxy tablet running KitKat 4.4 or higher, along with your cell phone running KitKat 4.4 or higher. And so let me show you guys how this works. It's probably easier to show you than just try to tell you. So let's go into the applications, and I'm going to go into SideSync 3.0 on both of these devices. Now on the cell phone, it's asking me to turn on my Wi-Fi. So even though it's asking me to do that, it will actually not connect to a Wi-Fi network. All it needs is just to turn on the Wi-Fi option to where they'd be able to find Wi-Fi Direct. And so these will actually be connected through Wi-Fi Direct, which is basically Bluetooth on steroids. So what you will first see next here is that my cell phone will turn off and it'll move all the way over onto the tablet. So this is actually really fun. If I move over onto the tablet over here, I'd be able to hit on this flashlight icon. And this right here is turning on the flashlight of the phone. Now let's say that there is some files on my tablet I would like to move over to my cell phone. This is all you would have to do. Head over into my files of the tablet, and let's say I would like to move over this video onto the phone storage. So you press and hold on whichever file you would like to move over. Once it's checkmarked, you press and hold and just drag and drop it onto the screen of your phone. And now you're just going to choose if you like it to be stored in the SD card or the device storage. Now, let's say you would like to do this vice versa. So I'm going to minimize on my SideSync. I'm going to close out of the tablet. Let's go back into SideSync of the cell phone. And again, I'm going to go over to where it says My Files, which is part of the cell phone. Let's go to Audio. And let's say I want to move over some of the music that I have on my device over onto the tablet. So I'm going to press and hold. And then I'm going to choose on three of these different songs. Again, press and hold so you'd be able to copy and paste those three. And now again on the tablet, you'd be able to choose where you'd like those to be stored. Let's move it over into music and done. And so now what you're doing is you're transferring all of that music that you just selected onto the tablet's device storage. Here's another thing that is great to have. Now let's say you have a movie on your cell phone, but you don't want to move it over to your tablet. So what you'd be able to do is you'd actually be able to expand the screen and make it huge. When I hit on play, now it'll actually minimize my SideSync, put it up over there as a floating widget, and then now it's going to be able to play my movie onto the tablet. You have your normal home button, recent app button, along with the back icon. Again, everything the exact same operational as your cell phone. So let's say I hit on the home button of the cell phone, it'll actually stop it on the tablet. And let's say I go into music and I would like to play a song really quick. What'll happen is if I switch it over to the tablet, it's actually playing right now from the phone. Now it's playing on the tablet itself. So as you can tell, everything is fluid when you go back and forth between the two. So now let's say that you have the Samsung Galaxy Tab S, as I do right in front of me, and someone was to shoot you a phone call and you had SideSync going on. Now if someone is calling you, you'd actually be able to answer it through here, or you'd also be able to decline it. And so as long as you have the Galaxy Tab S, then you're now it's transferring your Wi-Fi enabled tablet into something that has mics and speakers to be able to answer and take all of the phone calls. Now the only tablet that's able to do this is going to be the Tab S series. All of the rest are not able to. So all those other Galaxy tablets that is running on KitKat, you will not be able to do the phone call capabilities, but you will be able to do everything else along with being able to shoot some text messages. So if you hop over into the text messaging area of SideSync and you're able to send a text message, you will notice that this is going over strictly straight across into your cell phone as well. You'll also notice inside of SideSync, you will not be able to do the camera only because your tablet already has a camera built in, and so you will not be able to open that function. So one of the main questions that will pop up about SideSync is what is the range? How far can you go between your phone and your tablet before it gets disconnected? I'm going to tell everybody a football field. So you'd be able to go all the way up to 300 feet, but it also depends on what is in your way. If there's buildings, houses, trees, or an open field. There is different numbers out there, speaking about how far you can go, but if I state the smaller of all of the numbers, everybody will be happy. So let's just say a football field range for Wi-Fi Direct. Hope this helped you guys out, and if it did, make sure you guys hit on like and subscribe, and make sure you tell all your folks and all your families and friends, and even strangers, if they have some Samsung Galaxy devices, make sure they download SideSync 3.0. Have a great day.